Happy New Year! Thanks for joining us for New Year's Eve with the Chesapeake Children's Museum. Go ahead and get cozy or fancy, but let's get ready to have some fun. We want you to know that we appreciate all of your support and donations all throughout 2021, but now it's time to sit back and enjoy the show. Every 365 days, we celebrate new beginnings. Some countries may celebrate on different days, but they still celebrate a new year. Let's learn a little bit more about a Hindu New Year.
Diwali is a festival of joy and prosperity and a celebration of the victory of good over evil. This is the story of Ram and Ravan, a story related to this festival. Thousands of years ago, in the city of Ayodhya, there was a wise and good king named Dashrath who ruled along with his three queens and four princes. The eldest, Ram, and his beautiful wife Sita lived happily along with the other prince brothers and their wives. But one of King Dashrath's wives was jealous of Ram and demanded that he be exiled to the forest for 14 years so that her son Bharat be made king. Having once promised his wife to fulfill any wish of hers, the helpless king exiled Ram to the forest. And so, Ram set off on foot, accompanied by his loving wife Sita and loyal younger brother Lakshman. A few years into their exile, a demoness named Surpanakha saw Ram and fell for his looks. She asked Ram to marry her. Ram refused and asked her to go to Lakshman instead. But Lakshman also refused. Enraged, Surpanakha showed her true form and Lakshman cut off her nose and ears. The demoness went wailing to her brother, who was none other than Ravan, the demon king of Lanka. Ravan was furious and swore revenge. With the help of another demon who took the form of a golden deer, he distracted Ram and Lakshman and kidnapped Sita from their hut. When Ram and Lakshman returned, Sita was missing. They realized that something bad had happened while they were gone and immediately rushed to find her. On their way, they came across an army of monkeys and bears that agreed to help them. Among them was a monkey named Hanuman, who had once vowed to be at Ram's service. Now, Hanuman was no ordinary monkey. He could fly over mountains, change size at will, and had superhuman strength. He had the power to leap across oceans in a single stride. So, obviously, he ended up being Ram's strongest ally. It was Hanuman who finally found Sita, imprisoned in one of Ravan's beautiful gardens. Hanuman reassured Sita that Ram would be here soon to rescue her. He came back to Ram with Sita's whereabouts, and the army of monkeys, bears, and men marched to Lanka. Soon, a great battle started between the two mighty armies, and Ram's soldiers managed to kill all the demons except one, Ravan. The battle was now between Ram and Ravan. He gave Ravan one last chance to apologize and return Sita. Ravan instead rained down weapons on him. Ram too fought back relentlessly, but despite all his efforts, nothing seemed to kill Ravan. Finally, Ravan's brother Vibhishan told Ram that Ravan's weakest point was in his navel. Using an arrow given to him by the gods, Ram shot Ravan in the navel and killed him instantly. And so, Ram and his love Sita were finally reunited. Soon after, upon completion of their 14 years in exile, Ram, Sita and Lakshman returned home to find the entire city waiting for them. The streets were decorated with flowers and lamps, and there was happiness everywhere. And this is why, every year on Diwali, we see the streets, homes and offices lit up with lamps, like the city of Ayodhya, in celebration of Ram and Sita's homecoming.
New Year's Resolution by Pat Miller, illustrated by Kathy Ember. Squirrel pinned up her brand new Nut of the Month calendar. It's January 1st, the radio said, a great day to make a resolution. Make a resolution? Wondered Squirrel. How do you do that? Bear might know. She went to see Bear at the Lonewood Library. Happy New Year, he said. Same to you, Bear. Do you know how to make a resolution? Is it like making a snack? Bear laughed. Resolutions are more important than snacks. More important than snacks, said Squirrel. What is a resolution? A resolution is a promise you make to yourself to be better or to help others, Bear said. When we begin a new year, we make a fresh start. Wow, did you make a resolution? Asked Squirrel. I did, Bear answered. I resolved to teach others how to read. I'm going to teach Skunk as soon as she gets well. Oh no, Skunk is still sick, Squirrel thought as she hurried to Skunk's house for a visit. She forgot all about making a resolution. Skunk was sick of being sick. I'm stuck in bed until Dr. Owl says I'm better, said Skunk. I would rather be learning to read. That's my New Year's resolution. Squirrel knew how to cheer up her friend. She hid at the foot of the bed. She popped up and shouted, Boo! Skunk giggled. Hide and Skunk was her favorite game. Squirrel popped up again, Boo! And again, Boo! And by now, Skunk was laughing hard. Just then, Dr. Owl came by. Skunk, I can tell by your laughter that you are feeling much better, he said. Now you can visit Bear. Just make sure you have a healthy lunch first. Lunch, thought Squirrel. She headed toward the Hidey Hole Diner. Maybe someone there can help me with my resolution. On her way, she met Mole and Turtle. Mole was holding a map close to his nose. "What are you doing?" Squirrel asked. "Turtle and I resolved to plant a garden," said Mole, "but I can't find a good place to dig with all these trees." "Wait here," said Squirrel. She dashed up an oak tree and looked down. She spied Wildcat Creek and on its bank a perfect place for a garden. Squirrel scampered down and led Mole and Turtle through the woods to the edge of the creek. She helped them stake out string for the borders of the garden. "Thanks, Squirrel. I'll start digging right after lunch," said Mole. "Lunch," thought Squirrel, and she rushed away. She still hadn't thought of a resolution. At the diner, Squirrel chose a stool next to Porcupine. He looked grumpy. "What's wrong?" asked Squirrel. "I resolved to be less grumpy, so I'm trying to laugh more, but I can't think of anything funny." "I can help you think of something funny. Like, why did the squirrel run back and forth across the road?" "I don't know. Why?" asked Porcupine. "Because she was nuts," laughed Squirrel. Porcupine laughed too. "I get it. That reminds me, what's striped and bouncy?" "Tell me," giggled Squirrel. "Skunk on a trampoline," said Porcupine. Squirrel laughed herself right off the stool. Porcupine said, "That's a good one. I better write these down." And off he went to find paper and pencil. Squirrel felt left out. "Porcupine has a resolution. So do Bear and Skunk and Mole and Turtle," she thought. "I'm the only animal in the forest who hasn't made a New Year's resolution." Rabbit came to take Squirrel's order. "Would you like to try my New Year's special?" asked Rabbit. "Sure," said Squirrel. "Maybe it will help me make a resolution. I wish I knew how." "Think of a way to improve yourself, or a way to use what you're good at to help others," said Rabbit. Squirrel ate her lunch special and thought hard. Just then, Skunk came in. "I need a healthy lunch. Thanks to Squirrel, I'm feeling better." "Sit with me, Skunk," Bear called. "I see you brought our first book." Turtle and Mole came in next. "What do you have for two thirsty animals who just started a garden?" said Mole. "Squirrel found a terrific place for it," said Turtle. Porcupine hurried in. "Do you know why Bear said caw, caw?" Before anyone could answer, Porcupine said, "He was learning another language." All the animals laughed. "I didn't know you were so funny," said Mole. "Me either," said Porcupine. "Squirrel got me started." Rabbit said to Squirrel, "You're doing a good job on your resolution." "I didn't know I had one," said Squirrel. "Your actions are better than words. It looks like you resolve to help someone every day," said Rabbit. "Really?" asked Squirrel. "I did it! I made my very first resolution!" "Hooray for Squirrel!" shouted all the animals. It was going to be a very happy New Year. I resolved to help someone every day.
Here's how to make a New Year's Eve party hat. We're going to use a basketball because I don't have any children here to use. And I would recommend ages 3 and up because younger than that, it's hard for them
to
sit still.
Here's another noisemaker.
You need three. You take a full sheet of newspaper, put it over the head, and then masking tape is going to make the hat band. And you want to go from the eyebrows all the way around to the nape of the neck. It's kind of loud, which is another reason not to do it on younger children. You go two times around, it makes it really secure. We'll just leave it with one. And then roll it up. can leave some parts sticking out if you want, make an extra flare. And then you might have some leftover ribbons that can decorate. If you have tissue paper, you can ball that up, stick that on. There's some long ribbon that'll make a tassel. I'll put that in the back. But there you have it, New Year's Eve party hat.
It's a beautiful morning here on the farm today. The sun is shining. We're gonna sing and play. It's a beautiful morning. The rooster's waking us. We are so glad you're here. Thanks for joining us. Here inside a big red barn, there's always something to do. All the animals have jobs to help out farmers too. It's a beautiful morning here on the farm today. The sun is shining. We're gonna sing and play. It's a beautiful morning. The rooster's waking up. We are so glad you're here. Thanks for joining us. We are so glad you're here. Thanks for joining us.
Radio 体操第一。
Hey friends, I've been thinking a lot about bubbles lately. Let's blow some bubbles. I'm going to get out my bubble wand. Oh, let's dip it in the bubble water. Oh, so many. I'll dip it again. Do you have a lot of bubbles? Would look like. Here's how mine would look. My bubble is so tall, so tall, and so wide, and so round. Only family fits inside. And your bubble is, get ready, here we go, so tall, so tall, and so wide, so, so wide, and so round, and only family fits inside. Oh, my bubble plus your bubble, and a bubble in between. My bubble plus your bubble, and a bubble in between. That's how far we need to stay until it's not a bubble day. Say, friends, does it kind of feel like you're living in a bubble? Like you have a bubble, and your friends have a bubble, and then between you needs to stay another bubble? Yeah, it's kind of like that, isn't it? That's right. Well, I think it's kind of fun to think about it as a bubble day and see how long it takes us before we can just pop the bubbles and be all snuggly and huggy with our friends and play close. Well, I wonder, do you think this seems about far enough away as a bubble? Oh, that's a good bubble right there. Maybe you can practice putting my bubble and your bubble and a bubble in between. My bubble and your bubble, and a bubble in between. That's how far we need to stay until it's not a bubble day. That's kind of fun to think about. And then, when it's not a bubble day anymore, what do you think we'll do? What do you think we'll do? The bubbles will... They will pop, pop. Yay! That's right. Until then, in the mornings when it's a bubble day, you can get out your bubble wand and dip it in, pull it out, and look at all the pretty bubbles! And everybody can stay in their bubbles while they need to.
Here's another noisemaker. You need a plastic straw. You're going to flatten the very end of it about an inch, and I'm going to use my teeth. So about an inch there is flattened. And then you're snipping the end to a point. So we'll snip up on one side, snip up to the other side, and that's it. And what we've created is a reed instrument. So I'm going to use my lips to control these two tips here so that they're close together. And you just have to play around with it to get the sound that you want. Happy New Year!
Come join the fun every Thursday here at the Chesapeake Children's Museum for our Creek Critters Nature Walk.
Señorita mariposa, tú eres muy hermosa. Señorita mariposa, tú eres muy hermosa. Te quiero a ti. Little butterfly, you just caught my eye. Little butterfly, flying through the sky. I'm so happy you're alive. Con tus alas preciosas, cuando te posas en la rosa. Your pretty yellow wings, they make me wanna sing. Señorita mariposa, tú eres muy hermosa. Señorita mariposa, tú eres muy hermosa. Te quiero a ti.
Observe a safe social distance during the current emergency. The distance of 6 feet, or two hogs, or three good-sized rockfish, or one small rowboat. Hear ye, hear ye. 'Tis common sense that all citizens practice good sanitation and clean their hands frequently.
In my day, we didn't have hand sanitizer, public restrooms, or decent towels. I'd have to wipe my hands on the Tory.
Hear ye, hear ye. 'Tis common sense that all citizens wear a face mask when in public. You might chance to encounter another citizen, even whilst jogging.
It is common sense to have a face mask on hand. Mine is extra large.
Yo soy la gatita Carlota. Mi novio es el gato con botas, que usa el sombrero de copa y unos guantes colorados. Mi novio es un gato educado, que habla francés e italiano, que toca el violín con la cola, con las patas toca el piano. Ay, 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 mi chicos, yo por ti estoy fru fru. Dime miau, 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 mi gatito, mi chifus. Miau. Buenas noches, Gatita, Carlota.
Buenas noches, mi gato con botas.
Te invito a dar un paseo por lo alto del tejado.
No puedo, mamita ha salido. Ha ido a comprarme un vestido. Si quieres, te espero mañana, sentadita a la ventana. Ay, 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 mi chifus, yo por ti estoy frufru. Dime miau, 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 mi gatito, mi chifus. Miau.
Scavenger hunt. So, gather these items from around your house. We have a stuffed animal, an item to use to bake, a picture of people that you love, something that has a map, something that makes bubbles, three things that are yellow, something in your house that plays music, a book that has numbers, something find something, find all these things you can, and take pictures of them. Then you can put your pictures in the comments, or you can email them to us. Ready, set, go! If you need more time, feel free to take it, or you can come back and send the pictures later. We look forward to seeing your pictures. Thanks for playing.
One is an empty bottle, plastic of course. A film can would work if you have those, or an empty prescription bottle. A broken piece of balloon. We don't need a whole balloon, so one that's already burst, or you can cut one. And a rubber band to hold it all together. It is a lot easier to do it with a friend, but I'm going to use the table to help steady it. Stretch the balloon tightly over the end of your can, that's tight as a drum, and then secure it with the rubber band. Now take your two fingers and pinch the top of your drum. Wow, that's loud. Happy New Year!
Under the sea, under the sea. Me too. Okay, so we're going to do a song called Looking for a Lime. And in the islands where I'm from, in the Caribbean, a lot of the islands have this expression, a lime, and it's not just a fruit, it's
a party! Woo!
And when you're liming, what are you doing, Dawn?
You're hanging out with your friends, you're relaxing, you're just enjoying each other's company.
So we're liming here right now.
Yeah.
So during the song, we're going to be swimming
around the ocean, doing whatever stroke you want. That's a good one.
Backstroke. And then we're going to be swimming and we're putting on our
goggles. Put on your goggles, everybody out there. Can you see? Because you're going to be looking for a
lime, which is a
party.
That's right. So get ready to swim with us, all right?
From the Taino Indians, about why the coqui frog sings. There was once a beautiful goddess who fell in love with coqui, the chief's son. When he went out to fish, she made sure that he came back with a big catch. And he would thank her by singing to her. One evening, she turned herself into a maiden. And she visited Coqui. And they fell in love. She told Coqui that she would come back the next night when the moon came up. But when it came, it brought a very scary storm named Huracan. The sky turned black, and the winds howled. The goddess tried to protect Cookie, but Huracan took him away, and she never saw him again. She became so sad, and she missed him so much, that she created a tiny frog that will forever call out his name, Koki Koki.
Koki 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 Koki.
The end.
Koki
Koki. Okay, we'll give it a try once more. Watch me. Are you ready?
Yeah!
Okay, rumble! Okay, that was awesome. Let's give it a try once more. Rumble! 4, 3, 2, 1! Oh, well done, well done, well done, well done. All right. This is how we're gonna do. Okay, we're gonna go 1, 2, 3. 1. 1, 2, 3. Aha! 1, 2, 3. Further! 1, 2, 3. Aha! 1, 2, 3. Bigger! 1, 2, 3. Now 1, 2, 3. Aha! 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 2 times. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 3 times. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3.
Time for another great story. Shante Keys and the New Year's Peas by Gail Pyrenees Davenport, illustrated by Marion Eldridge. Happy New Year, Grandma, said Shante Keys. Mom said we'll eat lucky New Year's peas. Mercy, cries Grandma, I'm weak in the knees. I cook lots of food, but forgot black-eyed peas. Chitlins baked ham, macaroni and cheese, greens and hot cornbread, but no black-eyed peas. It's a year of bad luck if we don't eat cow peas. Quick, go to Miss Lee's and borrow some, please. Happy New Year, Miss Lee, says Shante Keys. Gram wants to borrow some black-eyed peas. My New Year is later because I'm Chinese. I'll make crisp golden dumplings instead of cow peas. I'm sorry to bother you, said Shante Keys. Come join us for dinner so you can try peas. I'll try at the grocer's, Mr. McGee's. Your aisles are stocked with such delicacies. Why can't I find lucky black-eyed peas? Back home in my Scotland, far overseas, for New Year's we toast and eat haggis and cheese. Happy New Year anyway, says Shante Keys. Come join us for dinner so you can try peas. Why don't you try asking Senior Ortiz? What do you eat for New Year's luck, Chef Ortiz? If you cook black eyes, may I borrow some, please? I am from Mexico, down by Belize. For luck, we make noise and eat grapes like these. Happy New Year anyway, says Shante Keys. Come join us for dinner so you can try peas. Next, Shante asks at her good friend Hari's, may I borrow peas for New Year's, please? We celebrate Diwali with other Hindu families. We light lamps and eat sweets, but no black-eyed peas. Thank you anyway, says Shante Keys. Come join us for dinner so you can try peas. Now Shante is frantic. She's in a time squeeze. She thinks hard and rushes to Auntie Marie's. I'd have too many if I cooked all of these. Hun, take what you need of my New Year's peas. Thanks, and come eat at Graham's with me, please. Grandma chops onions to cook with the peas. Auntie adds a coin for luck and a pinch of bay leaves. And Shante cooks rice as Mom oversees. Auntie says, Shante, can you get the door, please? Your friends are here for dinner. Come to try peas. The peas are delicious, the whole group agrees. Happy New Year and thank you, Shante Keys.
Hi, boys and girls. It's Kid Singer Tim. I put my green bandana hat band on, my cowboy hat, because I'd like to sing a very cool folk song for you called The Green Grass Grows All Around. This is a really fun song. Let me tell you just a couple things about it. First of all, it's got an echo part that you can do. So there's a little space that I'll leave. So as I go through the song like this, well, there once was a tree, a pretty little tree. That's room for you to echo each line that I sing. So just listen to what I sing and sing it right back. And there'll be enough space for that. And the other neat thing is, each time I go through the song and talk about the different parts of the tree, you have to go backwards through the parts. And you'll see how that develops as we go through the song. So let's get started. It says, the green grass grows all around. Well, there once was a tree. Tree and
And the green grass grows all around, all around. The green grass grows all around. Well, on that limb, there was a branch, the creepiest little branch that you ever did see. Well, the branch on the limb, and the limb's on the tree, and the tree's in the hole, and the hole in the ground, and the green grass grows all around. And the branch on the limb, and the limb's on the tree, and the tree's in the hole, and the hole in the ground, and the green grass grows all around, the green grass grows all around. Well, on that twig, there was a nest, the prettiest little nest that you ever did see. Well, the nest on the twig, and the twig on the branch, and the branch on the limb, and the limb's on the tree, and the tree's in the hole, and the hole in the ground, and the green grass grows all around, all around. The green grass grows all around. Well, in that nest, there was a bird, the prettiest little bird that you ever did see. Well, the bird's in the nest, and the nest on the twig, and the twig's on the branch, and the branch on the limb, and the limb's on the tree, and the tree's in the hole, and the hole in the ground, and the green grass grows all around, the green grass grows all around. Well, on that bird, there was a hat, the greatest little hat that you ever did see. And the bird's in the nest, and the nest on the twig, and the twig's on the branch, and the branch on the limb, and the limb's on the tree, and the tree's in the hole, and the hole in the ground, and the green grass grows all around, the green grass grows all around. And the nest on the twig, and the twig's on the branch, and the branch on the limb, and the limb's on the tree, and the tree's in the hole, and the hole in the ground, and the green grass grows all around, the green grass grows all around, the green grass grows all around.
That sure was a lot of fun. I hope you were able to sing along with me, guys. Thanks again. So glad to spend time with you. Again, I'm Kid Singer Jim. I'll see you guys the next time. Bye-bye.
Go.
Hi, everybody. We're live from Chesapeake Children's Museum. Hope you're enjoying your New Year's Eve celebration. You might be noticing my crown. I'm going to show you how to make one. All you need is a big piece of paper. If you don't have a big piece of paper, stapler or tape will help make smaller pieces of paper into one big piece of paper. You can cut it zigzag or cut it curvy. Since this one is zigzag, I think I'll go curvy this time. And again, if you don't have one big piece of paper, you might be making this in four pieces instead of two pieces. Then you want to put it together, and then we will measure it to fit. We will size it. So just like the newspaper hat, if you have the actual head that is going to wear the crown, that will help you to make perfect sizing. So this is now ready to be sized. This is a little easier to do on my own head. You just make it fit like that. And then that's where you'll staple it. Make a second ground. So if I change outfits, I can color coordinate. And if you have stickers or markers, you can decorate it any way you like. So that's another crown. Then we have something that for parades, you might have seen confetti, but we're going to make a confetti popper. And depending on where your celebration is, if you're doing an indoor celebration, you might use something like cotton, puff balls, pom-poms, cotton balls. If you're doing this outside, you could use something from nature. I picked up these. We'll call these gumballs. Okay, you cut the hole in the bottom of a cup. Tie a knot on the end of a balloon. That's going to help secure this balloon piece to the cup. So there's a knot. And then just cut the tip off of the balloon head. You don't want to cut too much. And we can also use a rubber band to help secure it. But this is going to go to the table again. Just like that. Good. I'm also holding it, but a rubber band would secure that. And let's go for the indoor pom-pom shooter. Just fill it with a bunch of pom-poms, something that's easy to clean up inside. And then when you get down to your countdown, everybody pops. Ta-da! Instead of fireworks. Let's see what else. Oh, around the world there are lots of different traditions. So depending on where you live in the world, or where your family is from, or what the people in your community are ethnic groups they belong to, one of the traditions from Latin America and from Spain is that at midnight, as the church bells in the town ring, for every chime, you pop a raisin or a grape in your mouth. So at the stroke of 12, we have 12 bongs, and this signifies 12 sweet months in the year to come. So 12 raisins or 12 grapes for the new year to come. And I have grapes here, just in case. If you live in India or have friends or family that are from that part of the world, there's a tradition that you leave a basket on your front steps. And in the evening, people will go from home to home with their own basket of limes and lemons and add one to the homes that are of people that they love. So this shows how many people care about you in your community. You put lemons and limes into a basket on their front steps. Another tradition is broken dishes, but I would start with dishes already broken. But that's something to make a lot of noise out in the street if you throw dishes around. And maybe you've also heard of pots and pans. I've got some pots and pans here. And these are easy to find. Hopefully you'll have some. Pots and pans. Something to hold in one hand and something to clang with in the other. Depending on how big your kitchen is, if it's not real big, you might want to take this outside. Sounds travels better in the outside. Clang on that. I've got some pots and pans. Is that it? I think that's it. So we're going to get ready for our countdown now. We're going to have to count 12 of something. So I thought since we have all those lemons, we can do that. Well, I just remembered one more. In Scandinavia, the tradition at midnight is you have a big family dinner. Lots of family all fit into one big room. And at the stroke of midnight, everybody steps on their chair, and then they jump into the new year. So that's something we can do, too. Make sure your chair is the right size for you. That's a good size chair for me to jump off of. So if we count to 12, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So get a close-up here. See if you can figure out which are the real
lemons and which are the plastic lemons? A traditional song for New Year's Eve that's from Scotland, and you may know the words or you may have heard the song, but this is traditionally sung as a way of remembering the fond times and the people that we love from times of old, from the year that's passed, and we're all looking forward to a very good new year. So 2021, start thinking about all the wonderful things that you want to have happen. Think of all the people that you want to stay connected with. And we can still connect through technology. We can still do some safe things outside if we keep a distance. Wearing masks is the best way to prevent germs from spreading. So let's all start imaging what are the things that we want to look forward to in 2021. And I know at Chesapeake Children's Museum, we're doing online things, getting better and better as we learn how to use the technology. We're going to be adding some things to the park. So if you've been to the museum, you know where we are, and we're in a 5-acre park that has woodlands and wetlands, nature trails. It leads down to the creek. You can watch the ducks and other animals. So we're going to be adding some other elements to the park, so you might be surprised. Next time you come, you can play outside and find lots of fun things to do.
Miss Debbie, why don't we go ahead and let everyone go grab something to make some noise with, or get a chair ready, or get some lemons to count down, pots and pans, maybe a noisemaker or a straw.
I got my straw ready. Did everybody make their straw?
And we will let them go gather their things, and we'll have them to get ready to count down in about 5 minutes.
Okay.
Okay. Bye. See you soon.
Celebrate the coming year, or have a fish fry on New Year's Day.
On New Year's, we spend time with friends and family until about 2 or 3 in the morning, and at midnight we eat 12 grapes for 12 sweet months to come.
For your year-end giving, and we appreciate all of your support to keep us moving forward into 2022. The Chesapeake Children's Museum is located at 25 Silipana Road in Annapolis, Maryland. 2021 has been a real doozy, so let's check it out. We are all so passionate about the museum. We are staying strong. And even better, we are still playing.
Along with your donations, we could use your support by joining our various outdoor and virtual programs we have to offer here at CCM.
We are grateful for the many grants and donations that continue to keep us afloat all year long. This year, despite the ongoing challenges of the pandemic, our volunteers and staff have helped us to build and grow. We are growing taller and louder with some of our new additions. Chesapeake Family Life magazine honors the Chesapeake Children's Museum as 2021's Family Favorite Play Places Around. And we congratulate Miss Debbie on being a 2021 Annie Awards recipient for arts education. And together, we do this for the children of our community and the children that come to visit the Chesapeake Children's Museum.
Children are going to be the last to be vaccinated. That's our audience. That's where our money comes from. And we need to stay alive until the point where they are ready to come back.
The Chesapeake Children's Museum. Our team at CCM says thank you for your end of year giving.
When's the dance party start?
Now!
Yeah. I thought love was only true in fairy tales. Then for someone else, but not for me. Shrek was out to get me. That's the way it seems. And I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace. It's out of my mind. I'm in love. Ooh, ooh, I'm a believer. Yeah. I could leave her if I tried. I thought love was more or less a given thing. In trying, all you get is pain. When I needed sunshine, I got rain. Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer, not a trace. It's out of my mind. I'm in love. Ooh, I'm a believer. I couldn't live if I tried. shredded to shreds.
That's the way it seems.
Shredded to shreds.
Disappointment haunted all my dreams. Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace. A doubt of my mind. Oh, I'm in love.
Ooh,
oh, I'm a believer. Yeah. I couldn't leave her if I tried.
Isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I've tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel. Don't let them know. Well, now they know. Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let it go, let it go. Turn away and slam the door. I don't care what they're going to say. Let the storm rage on. Cold never bothered me anyway. It's funny how some distance makes everything seem small, and the fears that once controlled us can't get to me at all. It's time to see what I can do. Test the limits and break through. No right, no wrong, no rules for me. I'm free. Let it go, let it go. I am one with the wind and sky. Let it go, let it go. You'll never see me cry. Here I stand, and here I stay. Everybody, make sure to check out the YouTube channel, like and subscribe. Kids Dance Party.
We are getting close to the new year. Is one more song and then it's time to ring in the new year.
Let's do it.
Really?
You guys better be ready to count from 10 to 0.
Let's introduce this next one.
This next song is called Sweet Caroline by Neil Diamond.
It's a great jumping song.
It's a great jumping song.
And there's some great sing-along parts in the chorus. We'll go ba, ba, ba.
Like a sheep.
And so good, so good, so good.
Like a very excited sheep. All right.
All right.
Do it.
I'll count it up.
Jumping sheep.
One, two, one, two, Batman time. When it began, well, I can't begin to know it. But then I know my friend Ian is strong. First in the spring, then spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Oh, hands, touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you. Oh, sweet Caroline.
Here comes ba, ba, ba.
Good times never seem so good.
So good, so good, so good.
Oh, I've been inclined,
ba, ba, ba,
to believe I never would. Oh, now I look at the night. And it don't seem so lonely.
So lonely.
I fill it up with only you. And when I hurt, the hurt rolls off my shoulder.
His shoulder.
But how could I hurt when I'm holding you? Oh, touching one, reaching out, touching me, touching me. Jumpy time.
I love jumping.
Yeah, sweet Caroline. Ba, ba, ba. Good times never seem so good.
So good, so good, so good.
Happy New Year's Eve. I think it's about that time.
I think it's about that time.
Should we do it, guys?
Countdown? Ooh.
And here we go.
You're doing it.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.
tradition on New Year's Eve is to have a big family meal, almost till midnight. And just before 12 o'clock, everyone climbs on their chair and we count down 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. New Year! We jump into the new year.
One, two, three!
Should old acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind? Should old acquaintance be forgot for old lang syne? For old lang syne, my dear, for old lang syne, we'll raise a cup and drink it up for old lang
New Year!
Happy New Year!